My brother Dominic DeAngelo, wrestling journalist, had a question. He asks, how did being a collegiate quarterback prepare you for the wrestling ring from a mental standpoint? What can you tell us about the transition from football to wrestling?
So different, so different. I mean, I was a quarterback, and if you know anything about quarterbacks, and I wasn't a quarterback that played a lot. I played, a good amount in my high school, especially my senior year. But when I went to college, I was just kind of a guy that was there. I was a backup. I was seventh string with 9 or 10 quarterbacks the first school I tried to go to, and then when I transferred to what is now Texas State University, I think we started camp with like 7 quarterbacks, and we still had like 5 by the time, the season started and whatnot. The quarterbacks don't get hit a lot. They're not asked to do a lot of physical stuff. It's more of a mental game. Yeah, you have to prepare yourself on a physical level to be able to play, but it's not the same as an offensive or defensive lineman. It's not the same as a linebacker or, even a running back or a wide receiver who, take the hits. Even in practices, they're getting hit pretty hard. In quarterbacks, we know we wore a pretty red jersey that told everybody stop. That's what red means. It means stop. If you've ever seen what's the movie with Keanu Reeves, the football movie?
The
The
replacements.
Replacements. Yeah. The one dude who just kept nailing him, and he goes, red means stop. And he goes, oh yeah, I see red, and I turned like a bull. Like it was such a great scene. That was real. That's real. Like you had a red jersey on. Even the low string quarterbacks were more or less protected because it was always that thought process, like, if the quarterbacks start going down, where do we go? And if we're just beating the crap out of even our scout team kids, then what are they? They're not going to be ready to get in the game if and when we need them.
Right.
So I didn't take a lot of hits in football, especially in college. So preparing me for wrestling, I think the one thing that football and sports in general will teach anybody, especially if they're trying to get into wrestling or any kind of athletic activity, is perseverance, because not everything is going to go the way you want it to go. It's not going to be easy for everyone all the time. There's some people who just naturally step into the ring, step into the limelight, and everything just from start to finish is immaculately amazing. And but for the vast, vast majority of people, there's ups and downs, there's injuries, there's yeses, and there's more no's than there are yeses. There's, more pitfalls than there are mountaintops, and you have to be willing to go through those hard and dark times to find your way to whatever mountaintop that you're trying to get to. It's not a straight path. I've been fired. I got fired from TNA. I got fired from WWE, and I never got fired from New Japan, but there were times when they would use me a lot, and there were times when I would hear nothing and be sitting at home, and it would be like 4 months, and I'd be like, "Hey, do I still have a job? What's going on?" It's the perseverance aspect of being in athletics or being in football, I think, that help prepare you for professional wrestling. Because again, there are a lot of no's, there are a lot of pitfalls, there's a lot of downtime, there's a lot of where you're just sitting around and you have no idea what's happening. And then all of a sudden, that light switch is turned on to whoever is making those choices, and all of a sudden that rocket ship, as they say, is stuck up your ass and off you go. But you have to be able and willing to go through all the dulls and lulls and low times and hardships and pains and injuries and no's and just the lack of understanding or knowing anything that's going on. And if you can do that, you have a chance. If you can say, okay, this is the direction I want to go, and then you hit a wall and you go, okay, I'm gonna go this direction, so I get around and go up and over and around and down and around through and all that stuff, you have a chance. If you can't, you won't. If you hit that wall as somebody who has no idea how to persevere through the worst of times, you'll never make it in anything, and especially professional wrestling.
Man, like sports, wrestling, a lot of it's kind of like the same mentality as like army, where it's like boot camp. Like, can you do it? Are you physically and mentally strong enough to withstand it? And that's honestly probably what separates people, right?
A lot of trophies and footballs behind you. Are those yours?
So I'm actually at my father-in-law's house, but I did play
Oh,
football.
okay. Yes.
Yeah.
Tell him to come
So
here. We can talk about this.
I'll take credit for it. Yeah, that's all mine. I did all
Yeah.
that.